Mr. Secretary General, thank you for this opportunity to discuss about security in a troubled part of Europe. First of all, Romanian officials asked for a permanent NATO base here in Romania. Are we going to have one?
Well, we are right now considering which further steps we should take to further strengthen our collective defense. And of course, that will also include considerations on what we call appropriate deployments. But it's a bit too early to say exactly how and where. But be sure we will not hesitate to take all the steps necessary for as long as required.
Can we expect such a discussion to be held in Wales in September?
Yeah, I would expect the NATO summit in Wales in September to take decisions on long-term measures to enhance our collective defense, because this is the core of our alliance, to provide effective defense and protection of our allies.
We've seen lately a lot of measures taken by NATO to reassure the allies, Romania included, of course. What other NATO movements of troops or technique should we expect here in Romania?
Well, we have already taken some steps, as you mentioned. We have deployed AWACS surveillance aircraft to improve our surveillance over Poland and Romania. You have seen more naval presence by NATO allies in the Black Sea. Further steps may be taken that will include an update of existing defense plans, development of new defense plans, enhanced military exercises, and, as I said, also appropriate deployment.
There's been quite a controversy here in Romania about Romania having a contingency plan within NATO. Does Romania have a contingency plan in NATO or not?
We never comment on the existence of contingency plans, but I can assure you that we have already all plans in place to ensure effective defense and protection of all allies. But of course, the new security situation after Russia's illegal military actions in Ukraine makes it necessary for us to update existing plans and also to develop new plans.
So you are saying right now that you are NATO is developing new plans for its allies. Can you mention what this means for Romania?
As a matter of principle, we never comment on the details in our defense plans. But as I said, I can assure you that, of course, as the world's strongest military alliance, we do have all plans in place to ensure effective defense of all allies against any threat. The Russian behavior in Ukraine has created a dramatically new security situation in Europe, and of course that makes it necessary for us to update our plans and develop new plans.
Thank you. Speaking about Russia, do you have any evidence at all of Russia pulling its troops from the Ukrainian border?
No, and that's a clear answer from my side. We don't have any visible evidence of a Russian withdrawal of military forces from the Ukrainian border. And actually, we have seen similar announcements from the Russian side in the past without any withdrawal of Russian troops. So we are very, very cautious when it comes to such statements. This is the reason why we continue to urge Russia to pull back its troops.
Speaking about Russia, the Romanian president said in a statement that he thinks that Russia wants to control the Danube River mouths. Do you have the same intelligence, the same information?
Well, again, we never comment on intelligence information. But there's no doubt that the illegal military actions in Ukraine go beyond Ukraine. This is about a long-term Russian goal to re-establish a sphere of Russian influence in the former Soviet space, and that includes many things. Also, a Russian interest in prolonging the conflicts in their near neighborhood, like in Transnistria, Abkhazia, south of Ossetia, and now also the illegal occupation of Crimea. And the Russians use these protracted conflicts to prevent these countries from seeking Euro-Atlantic integration in the EU and NATO.
Speaking about this behavior of Russia, do you fear that Russia will try to destabilize the Republic of Moldova the next weeks, just before signing the crucial treaty with the European Union?
I have no doubt that Russia will increase pressure on Moldova, maybe also Georgia, in the run-up to the finalization of these association agreements. We have seen that in the past. We will see it in the future as well, because that is the overall goal of Russia, to prevent these countries from seeking closer relations with the European Union and NATO.
Norway, Sweden, even Hungary spoke publicly about a raise in the Russian intelligence activity on their own territories. Do you have information about such a growing activity also in Romania?
No doubt that there is a growing Russian activity, which also goes beyond the traditional intelligence activity. We see clear evidence that Russia is also heavily engaged in spreading misinformation. It's a misinformation campaign, which includes influencing media as well as non-governmental organizations. So it's a very sophisticated approach with the aim to influence the public opinion as well as political decision-making processes in allied nations.
Speaking about this, the German Secret Service is worried about Bulgaria responding to the Russian command. We've seen an article published in the German press. Do you have similar worries about Romania too, being controlled somehow by Russia?
Well, I've just visited Bulgaria, and I have no reason to doubt Bulgaria's commitment to our alliance, as well as commitment to its EU obligations. But clearly, Russia is very active also when it comes to Bulgaria.
And what about Romania?
Well, I don't have concrete examples, but I would be surprised if Russia isn't active in Romania as well.
We had a political fight between the president and the prime minister here in Romania about the Supreme Defense Council pronouncing itself on Russia or not pronouncing. Can this fight be seen as a sign of weakness in a key ally country?
I'm not going to comment at all on domestic affairs in Romania.
And my last question, Ukraine is in such a critical point also because of the corruption and because of the oligarch that had such a huge power that threatened the state itself. It's not me who is saying this, but the former state secretary Hillary Clinton. Do you think this corruption is also a danger in other Eastern European countries?
Well, I think the efforts to fight corruption is a long-lasting effort, and all governments should focus on that. I mean, it was one of the accession criteria for joining the European Union as well as NATO, that governments commit themselves to a determined fight against corruption. So whenever we see examples of corruption, it should be punished severely, and governments should devote a lot of efforts to fight that scourge.
Mr. Secretary General, thank you very much indeed.
You're welcome.